much, just a few things, but I hope it will be helpful.
Okay. Is she going to teach again or just one class?
Now she said that since she got good response, so she will ask the students which day is convenient for the students, and according to that she will do the adjustment, Maharaj. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Nice. You're learning. You're getting more education, right? So you can be a better devotee. Are you working? Do you have a job?
Sorry, Maharaj, I couldn't hear.
Do you have a job?
No, Maharaj, I'm not doing job. I'm helping the house business, Maharaj. And now I want to start my own.
Are you going to start your own business, huh?
Yes, Maharaj.
What about your sister? What about your sister? Is she going to help you?
We are planning to... we're going to do in partnership, Maharaj.
That's nice.
She's 50 and me 50.
What kind of business?
Event management, Maharaj.
Oh.
So we have to do the management.
Mm-hmm.
Because we also have previously degree in management, so this is gonna, and the event is actually our passion, so we want to join together and do the event planning together.
Manage birthday parties.
Yes, Maharaj.
Manage celebrations, many things.
Yes,
Maharaj. Nice.
Thank you, Maharaj.
So you're happy there in Burma?
Yeah, materially it's good, but spiritually everything is lacking, Maharaj.
Really?
We miss Thailand for that. Wow. Yes, Maharaj. It's not so easy like Thailand. Lots of issues, we don't know where to go, what to do. Sometimes we don't know what to do at all, like this kind of situation comes. So we miss Thailand a lot in these times.
Oh.
According to me, Maharaj, for me it is like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So should we begin?
Yes, Maharaj, we should begin. I think we're late already. 5 minutes.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Narayanam Namaskrityam Naram Chaiva Narottamam Daivim Sarasatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudirayat Nasta Prayeshu Vabhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki. So we're going through Prahlad Maharaj's prayers offered to Lord Nisringadev, which is given to us in the 7th canto, the 9th chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam.
हामीले चाहिँ प्रह्लाद महाराजको वन्दना जुन नरसिंह भगवानलाई गर्दै हुनुहुन्छ त्यसको बारेमा चर्चा गर्दैछौँ र श्रीमद् भागवतमको चैप्टर कैंटो 7 र चैप्टर 9 बाट गर्दैछौँ.
So Prahlad Maharaj was describing about the creation, and he described how Lord Brahma took birth from the lotus flower and could not understand where he came from.
र प्रह्लाद महाराजले चाहिँ यो सृष्टिको बारेमा बात गर्दै हुनुहुन्थ्यो र कसरी ब्रह्माजी चाहिँ कमलको फुलदेखि उत्पन्न जन्मिनुभयो र जन्मेर मलाई चाल पाउनु भएन कि उहाँ कतादेखि आउनुभएको कहाँदेखि आउनुभएको भन्दै.
So then, Brahma, he went into the bottom, tried to find the source of the lotus flower. He searched for a long time. He couldn't find it.
Brahma ji chai aafno jo kamal ko jo kamal ko phool ko jo bhetna chha tesko tala tala gayera khojnu bhayo kahan dekhi yo utpanna bhayeko to janna koshish garnu bhayo prayas garnu bhayo tara jaso garda pani waha le jannu bhayena.
Now usually if we want to know where we came from, we'll go to our mother and we'll ask the mother, where did I come from?
हामीलाई जब जान्न चाहन्छौँ कि हामी कहाँदेखि आएका हौँ त्यतिखेर चाहिँ हामीले मातालाई गएर प्रश्न गर्छौँ.
But Lord Brahma is a bit different because Lord Brahma was born without any mother. So it was very difficult for him.
र ब्रह्माको बात चाहिँ अलिक भिन्दै थियो किनभने ब्रह्माको चाहिँ माता हुनुहुने थिएन वा माताबाट उत्पन्न हुनुभएको थिएन.
And so he just took shelter of the lotus flower. He thought, I'm born from the lotus flower. So he took shelter of the lotus flower and he sat there on the lotus flower and he did austerities for a long time, hundreds of years. And then he realized that the Supreme Lord was spread throughout his own body.
The what, Maharaj?
The Supreme Lord was all through his body. Yes. His whole body was the Supreme Lord. The example is given, just like there's a special fragrance in the earth, the aroma, the scent, it's in the earth, but you can't see it, it's very subtle.
जस्तो कि हामीले उदाहरण दिनुहुन्छ महाराजले हावामा जो खुसबु हुन्छ त्यो चाहिँ हामीले देख्न सकिन्न तर के हुन्छ हामीले महसुस गर्न सकिन्छ कि त्यहाँ गन्ध छ खुसबु छ भन्दै.
So Lord Brahma, he realized the Lord was everywhere in everything.
र ब्रह्मालाई चाहिँ यो एहसास भयो कि भगवान चाहिँ हर जग्गा सबैमा हुनुहुन्छ भन्ने.
And then he saw the Lord appearing before him in the universal form. He could see him having many, many faces, thousands of faces and feet and heads and hands. And he was very nicely dressed with all kinds of ornaments and he was also carrying weapons. And he was covering the whole universe. His legs were at the bottom. At the bottom of the universe, from the lower planets, and he went all the way up to the top of the universe. So Lord Brahma, he had become very pure by doing its austerity, by sitting on the lotus flower. He could actually see Lord Vishnu. So he had become self-realized. He could realize his own self and he could see also the Lord.
त्यसो गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ ब्रह्माजीले आफ्नै आफको अस्तित्वको बारेमा थाहा भयो, आत्मबोध भयो उहाँलाई, र उहाँले जान्नुभयो कि म को हुनुहुन्छ
भने. Lord Brahma could see the form of the Lord. The form of the Lord is called that form which he saw with many, many arms and legs and heads. That's called the Mahapurush.
Brahmajile jo bhagwan ko hajar hajar haat khutta ra muh kheru bhayeko jo roop dekhnu bhayeko thyo tela chai maharoop bhande bhaninchha.
Arjuna also saw Krishna the same way. He'd seen that form from Krishna. Krishna showed him that form. And after he saw the whole day, nothing happens. Then when I give class, somebody starts calling me. Because they had to tell me what time the class is tomorrow. Okay, so Arjuna also saw that form of the Mahapurush. So we can understand the form of the Lord is not impersonal. He has form, he has features, he has hands and legs, he has arms, he has a head, he's a person. The form of the Brahman cannot have these kind of features. He cannot have hands and legs and ears and eyes. So Brahma was able to see the actual form of the Lord. That's the result of his perfect knowledge, because he had perfect knowledge, he purified himself and he knew the truth. So he was qualified to see the Supreme Lord. And that's why he was able to surrender unto the Supreme Lord, be a devotee. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, after many births and deaths, then one is actually in knowledge, then he surrenders to me. Such a soul is very rare. It's very rare. So we should understand what is the goal of knowledge. The goal of knowledge is to surrender to the Supreme Lord. Sometimes people are really stupid and they think the goal of knowledge is to become God. And sometimes they think the goal is to merge into God and become one with Him. So Brahma didn't make any of these mistakes. He understood what is actually the position, that the Lord is a person, and he was able to see that form of the Lord.
यसरी ब्रह्माजीले चाहिँ केही गल्ती गर्नु भएन र उहाँले चाहिँ स्वयं बुझ्न सक्नुभयो कि भगवान चाहिँ पुरुष नै हुनुहुन्छ भन्ने.
So Madhvacharya, the great Acharya in the line of our disciplic succession, he gives a nice example to understand this. He says that Lord Brahma saw the Supreme Lord pervading the universe in a subtle form.
Brahma, he
saw the Supreme Lord was everywhere, all over the universe, but in a subtle form. There's a fragrance, there's an aroma, and there's colors also in the earth, but they're in a subtle form. We see that when you go in the garden, if you do gardening, if you plant some seeds in the ground, you know, the flowers will come up, and one flower will be red, another flower will be yellow. They come up all different colors. Where do they get the color from? The ground. And the flowers have also different smells, different aromas, they have different fragrance. And where do the seeds don't have any smell, but when they grow into flowers, they have a nice smell. All different flowers have different smells. So the Supreme Personality of Godhead, He works the same way. Just like the earth has all colors and smells, the Supreme Lord is everywhere. But you cannot see.
भगवान पनि त्यस्तै हुनुहुन्छ जस्तो कि हामीले अघि फुलको उदाहरण लिएका थियौँ सुगन्ध पनि मिल्छ रङ पनि मिल्छ त्यसै गरी भगवान पनि हुनुहुन्छ तर हामीले चाहिँ भगवानलाई एहसास देख्न सक्दैनौँ तर एहसास गर्न सकिन्छ.
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, Matak parataram nanyat kinchidasti dananjaya mai sarvamitam proktam sutrimanikana eva. Krishna said, there is no truth superior to me. Everything rests on me, Krishna said. Everything rests on me, just like pearls are strung on a thread. Just like we're all wearing.
Okay, Maharaji, say first.
Go ahead, you finish.
Yes, thank you, Maharaj. Ani, just like euta dhago ma moti ka, jab moti ko mala huncha, dhago huncha ra moti ka geda hair huncha. Tesai gari bhagwan huncha ra bhagwan mathi sabai moti ka dana jastai aera rest garchan.
So devotees wear kunti mala, wear tosi beads around the neck, but we don't see the thread, you only see the bead.
जस्तो कि भक्तहरूले सबैले तुलसी माला कन्ठी माला लगाउँछौँ र त्यसमा चाहिँ के हुन्छ त भन्दाखेरि धागो देखिन्न, माला मात्रै देखिन्छ, बीज गेडा मात्रै देखिन्छ तुलसीको.
The beads are all held together by the thread, but you don't see the thread. The same way Krishna holds everything together in this universe, but we don't see Him.
Just like ye tulsi mala, hamile dhago chha dekhina, tara sabai jo tulsi ka geda geda hai chai, to rasi le nai thamera rakheko chha. Tesai gari bhagwan jo hunuhuncha, wale yaha sabai thamera rakhnu bhayeko chha, tara hamile chai to dekhna sakindaina.
So Lord Krishna says, He's the highest truth. There's no truth above Him. He's the top. Only Krishna says that. Nobody else can say that. Shiva cannot say, Brahma cannot say, Durga, Ganesh, none of them can say that.
र यो चाहिँ अरू कसैले पनि भन्न सक्नुहुन्न, शिवजीले पनि भन्न सक्नुहुन्न, गणेशले पनि भन्न सक्नुहुन्न, दुर्गाजीले पनि भन्न सक्नुहुन्न, कसैले भन्न सक्नुहुन्न.
But Krishna himself says this in the Bhagavad Gita.
So Krishna swayamle chai yo Bhagavad Gita ma bhannuhuncha.
So Lord Brahma, Prahlad Maharaj continues, he's offering his prayers to Lord Nrisingadev. And he tells Lord Nrisingadev about a previous incarnation.
Prahlad Maharaj ji, Narsimha Maharaj, Narsimha Bhagwan lai yo bhandai hunuhuncha, wale yo srishti ko barema charcha gardai hunuhuncha.
Right. That Prahlad Maharaj reminds Lord Nrisingadev, he said that previously you appeared in the form of as High Griva, you had a head of a horse.
Prahlad Maharaj le Narsimha Bhagwan lai yo yad dilaunu huncha ki pujyo pahila ko avatar ma chai tapai High Griva bhayera aunu bhayeko thiyo, tapai ko tyeti khera jo sar chha tyo chai ghoda ko roop ma thiyo.
And at that time you killed two demons named Madhu and Kaitaba. And these two demons, they were full of Rajagun and Tamagun, and they'd stolen the Vedas from Brahma. So Lord Vishnu came in the form of High Griva and killed them and took back the Vedic knowledge and gave it to Lord Brahma. So at that time, the Lord showed how He cares to protect His devotees. He killed the demons.
Yeah, they had
attacked Lord Brahma. So Lord Vishnu came as High Griva and killed them. So same way sometimes devotees get attacked by demons. But we should have faith that the Lord is always there and He's going to protect us. But devotees are always willing, we take a risk to try to spread Krishna consciousness. But the demons are all full of rajagun and tamagun. They're always against the devotees and they give devotees trouble. So we as devotees, we want to cultivate the mode of goodness and understand better the Lord, how He is transcendental. And then we can have faith that if there are any problems, if we face any difficulties, the Lord will help us to remove all the problems. One devotee was saying to Prabhupada, he said, Prabhupada, I'm having so many difficulties trying to be a devotee, so many problems. So Prabhupada said to him, with one kick of my foot, I will kick away all these problems, I will smash all the problems. So, Krishna is a person also, and if we have difficulties, Krishna is always there to help us. Krishna has the Lord or Krishna or Vishnu, his form is always transcendental and always blissful. People cannot understand why the devotees are so happy. But because Krishna is happy, we are happy. Even when Krishna comes to kill the demons, it's pleasure, it's all enjoyment for him. It's not difficult for Krishna to come and kill the demons. He can easily do it. So then Prahlad Maharaj goes, tells Lord Nrisingadev that you appear in many different forms. Right, he has many different incarnations. Sometimes he comes as a human, just like he came as Lord Krishna and Lord Rama. Sometimes he comes as an animal, like half animal, Lord Nrisingadev. Sometimes he may be a demigod or he may be a great sadhu.
Kokavela
And we know he also comes as Matsya and Kurma, comes in these forms, fish and tortoise. So when he incarnates, his purpose is two things: to give pleasure to the devotee and kill the demons. And according to the age, according to the, like Kali Yuga or Satya Yuga, he will protect the principles of Dharma. But then Prahlad says, in the Kali Yuga, you don't come. You only come in three yugas. You only come in the Satya Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, but you don't come in Kali Yuga. You don't show yourself anyway. You hide yourself. So we see how the Lord Vishnu comes to protect Brahma. We told how he came as Haigriva with a horse head, and he killed the two demons, Madhu and Kaitava. And he also came to protect Prahlad. So Lord Chaitanya also comes in the Kali Yuga to protect the devotees and protect the fallen souls, to protect everyone. So Lord Chaitanya is the Supreme Lord, but he never tells anybody he's the Supreme Lord. And if anybody would say he was the Supreme Lord, he would cover his, he'd block his ears and he would deny it, say, no way, say, don't be stupid, I'm not God. So he was like, Lord Chaitanya was disguising himself as a devotee. He just wanted to be a devotee. He didn't want to be God. He knew that if he said that he was God, then there would be many other people who would say they are also God. Just like if you go to Kumbh Mela, there's so many people, so many different groups there, and they will tell you their guru is God.
Mm.
And so they would say, come and meet our guru, he's the Kali Yuga avatar. So Lord Chaitanya, he didn't want any of that, but he just came to establish, he came to teach the Sankirtan, to get everybody to chant the holy name. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, the appearance of Lord Chaitanya is described in the 11th canto.
Srimad Bhagavatam ko 11th canto ma Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ko siri aunu bhayeko chha tesko bare ma bataeko chha.
Karabachana Muni is speaking to Nimi Maharaj, Maharaj Nimi. Maharaj Nimi wanted to know about the incarnations in each age.
Karabachana Muni le chai Maharaj Nimi lai esko barema bhanera bataudai hunuhuncha ra Maharaj Nimi lai chai har yug ko jo avatar chha tesko barema sodhdai hunuhuncha.
So Lord Chaitanya is the Kali Yuga avatar.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu jo hunuhuncha waha chai Kali Yuga ko avatar hunuhuncha.
In each age, there's just like in the Satya Yuga, the Lord comes in a white form and to teach meditation.
Just like Satya Yuga, man, that he says, "Bhagwan, say to avatar ma anuhuncha."
And then the Treta Yuga, he came in a red form, a red colored form, to teach about yagya, to do yagya. And then in the Dwapara Yuga, he came as Krishna, a black form, to teach deity worship. And in the Kali Yuga, he comes as, in the yellow color as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to teach Sankirtan. So in each age, the Lord comes in a different color. So Lord Chaitanya is not a Leela avatar. In the Kali Yuga, there's no Leela avatars, but there are Yuga avatars. So when Prahlad Maharaj said, you don't come in the Kali Yuga, it means you don't come as a Leela avatar. But he comes in every age. Sambhavami yuge yuge. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, I come in every age. So then Prahlad Maharaj starts speaking about himself. He says that my mind is very sinful and lusty.
And
sometimes I'm happy and sometimes I'm miserable.
Kotu bela chama ekdum khushi hunchu ra kotu bela chama ekdum dukham ma ekdum
I'm always thinking how to get more money. So my mind is very contaminated. I'm never satisfied. So I'm a very fallen soul. How can I ever be able to talk about your activities? Actually, Prahlad Maharaj is a great soul. He's not really, but he's taking the part of taking the position of, he's talking like he's a common man. Prahlad Maharaj is always in the Vaikuntha planets, in the spiritual world. But he's telling Lord Narsingadev that, you know, I'm very poor, I'm very fallen, I've got so many material desires. So when we always do sinful activities, then we will have sinful desires. And anything which has no relationship to Krishna is sinful.
So we
have to understand Krishna's instruction in the Bhagavad Gita when he tells Arjuna to surrender. If we surrender to Krishna, then we can get free from all our sinful reactions. We're suffering because of our sinful reactions, because of all the nonsense things we've done. So if we have not surrendered to Krishna, it means we're sinful. Means we don't have proper knowledge, means we're in Maya. We have to purify our mind by the chanting of the Maha Mantra. In every age, there was different processes like meditation, temple worship, and sacrifice. But in those ages, you could also chant the Maha Mantra as well. That other process, you had a choice. But in the Kali Yuga, we have no choice. There's only one way, the chanting of the holy name. So Srimad Bhagavatam says, Tasmat Sankirtanam Vishnu Jagan Mangalam Amhasham. That the Sankirtan, the chanting of the holy names of the Lord, can give us, it can destroy all types of sinful reactions. Sometimes people ask me, how can I atone, how can I do prayaschit for my sins? I tell them, just chant Hare Krishna. But don't keep doing sinful activities, you have to stop. If you keep doing sins, then you are a rascal. And you will suffer. You deserve to suffer. So Prabhupada explains there's no any other process except for the chanting of the holy name will never help you. You have to chant the holy name. We have to fix the mind on Krishna, and the only way to fix the mind on the Lord is by chanting His name. And if we chant nicely, then we can get free of all of our problems. So Prahlad Maharaj talking to Lord Narsingadev about his own problem, he said, I'm like a man who has got many wives. Just like if you have many wives, you know, it's not easy. You have to keep them all happy. You have to pay attention, please, every one of them. So the same way, Prahlad Maharaj said that my senses all demand attention. My tongue wants to eat very tasty food. And I want to have sex with a beautiful woman. And even though my stomach is full, I want to eat more and more food. And my ear doesn't like to hear about you. Whenever they hear spiritual sounds, it will go away.
उनलाई चाहिँ त हजुरको बारेमा सुन्न मन पर्दैन जब हजुरको बारेमा केही पनि आउँछ मेरो कानले मतलब राख्दैन
But my ears very eager to hear cinema songs, Bollywood songs. And the same, I have the same problem. My nose wants to smell the pleasant thing, very nice, pleasing thing. My eyes are always looking to see something to please my eyes. So you can see I'm having a lot of trouble with all these senses. They're just like wives. So devotional service, the process of bhakti yoga, is to help us to get purified. And if we're not trained, if we're not trained in how to purify the senses, then we'll never be able to become a devotee. Right? Prabhupada writes, if you read the Nectar of Instruction in the preface, it says there, the first business in spiritual life is to control one's mind and senses. So you want to become a devotee, the first thing you have to do is control the tongue. Just like we say that prayer, Sharira Avidya Jao, everyone knows that prayer, right?
Yes, Maharaj, hopefully.
When we say that prayer, everybody wakes up, everybody's thinking, where's the prasadam? And when we say Om Namo Bhagavate, everybody goes to sleep. So, Sharira Vijaya, of all the senses, the tongue is the most difficult to control. So we have to pray to Krishna to help us to control the tongue. So we train people to become vegetarian, don't eat meat, don't eat unclean things like fish and eggs and meat, eat pure food. And we have to tell people not to smoke, not to drink alcohol, not even to drink tea or coffee.
हामीले यो पनि भनेर बताउनु पर्छ अरूहरूलाई कि रक्सी पनि नपिउनु र सलाई पनि नफुक्नु र चाय र कफी पनि नपिउनु
And people should also not be having sex unless they want to have a child. Right. If we don't control our senses, then we cannot make advancement in Krishna consciousness. And if we want to control the mind and senses, we have to chant the holy name of Krishna. Just like a man who has many wives, he has a difficult time. He's always got problems taking care of the wives. So we will stop now. Is there any question from anyone? No questions. Yes?
Hare Krishna, kasi prashna cha?
Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, Dandabhat Pranam.
Hare Krishna, Dandabhat Pranam.
Mataji, you have a question, eh? Again, Guru Maharaj, one of you, in real life training, didn't got a training D and a bunny, Bhakti Mahaprabhu, you're gonna suck in now, one of you.
Ajay.
A good training, Jacob Saturday, you never.
Maharaj, Bhagavad Grandma Prabhuji is asking that just a while ago you said that we have to train our mind. So how do and senses? So how do we give them training?
We go to temple and stay with the devotees. Or if you're not going to go to temple, you have to do in your home like what devotees do in the temple. You must wake up early in the morning. Wake up. Prabhupada said by 4 a.m. you should get up. And then you do Mangal Arti, worship Tulsi, chant Hare Krishna, read Srimad Bhagavatam. Then you cook for the deities, offer your food to Krishna, eat prasadam. This is a niyam. These are the rules and regulations. This is how you control, this is a training.
Training.
You do it every day. Then you can go to work in the daytime, you come home at night, and then you do take prasada and read Bhagavad Gita, do some kirtan, like that. Is it clear? Okay.
Hare Krishna. Dhanabhat Pranam Maharaj.
Hare Krishna. Dhanabhat Pranams.
Evda Prasna Sai Mataji.
Ajay.
अघि महाराजले भन्नुभयो चैतन्य महाप्रभुले यहाँ धरतीमा हुँदाखेरि कसैले उहाँलाई भगवानको अवतार हुनुहुन्छ, भगवान स्वयं हुनुहुन्छ भन्दाखेरि कान थुनेर चाहिँ राम राम भन्नुहुन्थ्यो भन्ने कुरा, यहाँ विष्णु विष्णु
भन्नुहुन्थ्यो
यो भागवतमा चैतन्य भागवतमा यो कुरो आउँछ र महाप्रभुले स्वयं भागवतमा अब त्यसो लेखिरहेछ अनि स्वयं पनि त्यसरी रियाक्ट गर्नुहुन्छ भने अहिले हामी भक्तहरूले उहाँलाई भगवान्को रूपमा उहाँले अन्न ग्रहण पनि गर्नुहुने थिएन, तुलसीको पूजा इत्यादि गर्नुहुन्थ्यो र त्यसलाई अहिले हामीले कुन तरिकाले यहाँनिर हामीले पुजिँदैछ भन्दा कुरा पहिला चाहिँ मन्दिरका विग्रहमा तुलसी पत्र नचढाउने, एकादशीमा एकादशी फलाहार गराउने हो त्यस्तो खालका नियम थिए, अहिले इस्कनमा किन परिवर्तन भएर के कस्तो खालको भावले त्यो अहिले पूजा हुँदैछ भन्ने कुरालाई अलिकति जानकारी चाहिएको थियो र जान साँच्चै जान्नको लागि है यो महाराजलाई यसो सोध्न पाएको थियो यो प्रश्न लामो भयो तर बुझ्न त बुझ्यो होइन भन्न खोजेको कुरो चाहिँ स्वयं चैतन्य महाप्रभुले
What's the question?
Just a minute. I'm confirming his question if I get it correct.
Okay.
The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu le afai aflai bhagwan accept garnu hune thiyena tara ani
अघि महाराजीले भन्नुभयो महाप्रभुले भगवान् भन्नुभयो भने कान थुनेर भगवान्को नाम लिनुहुन्थ्यो विष्णु विष्णु भन्नुहुन्थ्यो भने अनि हामीले पहिला यो सुरु सुरुमा इस्कन अलिक पहिला इस्कनमा पनि हामीले भगवान् चैतन्य महाप्रभुलाई यहाँ बर्मामा अब अरूतिर जानिएको थिएन तुलसी पत्र चढाउने थिएन अनि भोग अन्न भोग लगाइने थिएन एकादशीमा अहिले फेरि त्यो लगाइन थाल्यो अनि त्यो किन हो र कस्तो भावले हो भन्ने
प्रभुजी इज आस्किङ द्याट जस्ट एज यु मेन्सन्ड इन द क्लास just a while ago that when somebody used to call Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as supreme lord he never used to accept so he is asking that some few years ago some decades ago he's saying that that time they used to not offer tulsi to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and an ekadash on his lotus feet they used to not offer tulsi on his lotus feet but instead a stick on his hand but and also on ekadashi days they used to not feed him grains but these days like recently the mood has changed the mood of worshiping Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has changed and now it is okay to offer tulsi and also grains so what kind of mood has it been like changed in ISKCON like before it was not possible and now we can do it is there any change in the mood Maharaj he wants to know that
well the devotees have become a bit more knowledgeable about how to do things, you know, they're learning as they grow older.
They get... Maharajle bhannuhuncha ki bhaktaharu jati thula hundai gaye ajhai gyan uhalai prapta hundai gayo ra tyaskaranle
You see, Lord Chaitanya, he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, are we worshipping him as a devotee or are we worshipping him as the Supreme Lord?
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu jo ho, wahan chai swayam bhagwan nai hunuhuncha, tara hamile wahalai bhakta ko roopma sewa garincha ki hamile wahalai bhagwan ko roopma sewa garincha.
Some people even they don't like to put the peacock feather on the head of Lord Chaitanya because they say that's not his mood.
र कोई कोई व्यक्ति चैतन्य महाप्रभु को जो मकुट सर में मयूर पंख पनि लगाइदिन किनभने मलाई यस्तो लाग्छ कि त्यो मुड्ने हैन चैतन्य महाप्रभुको.
So some people they're worshipping Lord Chaitanya as a devotee, and some people they worship him as the Supreme Lord.
र कुनै कुनै जो भक्तहरू हुनुहुन्छ उहाँहरूले चाहिँ भगवान चैतन्य महाप्रभु हो भन्दै सेवा गर्नुहुन्छ र कसै कसैले चाहिँ भक्त हो भन्दै त्यसरी सेवा गर्नुहुन्छ.
They worship Lord Chaitanya, that he has come from the spiritual world and his body is transcendental. But other people, they like to keep Lord Chaitanya in the mode of being the devotee.
र अरू अरूलाई चाहिँ यस्तो लाग्छ कि चैतन्य महाप्रभु चाहिँ भक्त नै हो भन्दै यसरी उहाँहरूले चाहिँ आफ्नो विचार प्रकट गर्नुहुन्छ.
So it's different. Different temples do different things.
र अलग अलग मन्दिरले अलग आफ्नै तरिकाले नै गर्दछन्.
Some pujaris are different from other pujaris.
र पुजारीहरूले पनि भिन्न भिन्न प्रकारकी सेवा गर्छन्.
Not that the mood has changed, but different people have different understandings. But the mood is still there to worship, to give worship.
तर जो भाव हो त्यो चाहिँ के हो त भन्दा कुन भाव छ त भन्दाखेरि त्यही सेवा गर्ने नै भाव छ, पूजा गर्ने नै भाव छ.
We're worshiping Lord. We worship Lord Chaitanya. You know, we don't worship him as a sannyasi. You don't see Lord Chaitanya anywhere in the temple as a sannyasi. You see him with the long hair and dressed in beautiful clothes. He's not a sannyasi. We don't worship him in the form as a sannyasi. Definitely, tosi leaves, you know, to put. Well, again, you know, as you say, if they're worshipping him as a devotee, then they won't put tosi on his feet and they won't put peacock feather on his head.
सबैले भगवान श्री कृष्ण र बलरामकै रूपमा पूजा गरेका छन्. तर पूजा गरेर के हुन्छ भने राधा कृष्णको पूजा गर्दा चाहिँ एकदम नियम कडा हुन्छ र कृष्ण बलरामको पूजा गर्दा चाहिँ मतलब गौरीदाईको चाहिँ अलिक कपटाना गर्न हुन्छ, जे पाए त्यही गर्न, अलिकति नै अब मनमोजी गरे जस्तो खालको सेवाको भाव देखिन्छ. झन् चैतन्य महाप्रभु त स्वयं राधा कृष्ण भएपछि बलराम पनि भएपछि तिनवटा व्यक्तिको पूजा गर्दा झन् ठुलो पूजा हुनुपर्ने हो कि हो त्यस्तो कपटाना गर्न सकिन्छ भन्ने विचार नि अब त्यसको बारेमा.
Maharaj, he has one more question. Like he is saying, when we worship Radha and Krishna, then the rules and regulations are really high and strict worship of them. But when we see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is a combination of Radha and Krishna himself, and Nityananda Mahaprabhu is Balaram himself. So actually, he's talking about in Myanmar mostly, because he has not seen outside like this, so he's talking about Myanmar. when we see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, so actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a combination of Radha and Krishna, and Nityananda Mahaprabhu is Balaram. So we are worshipping three personalities together. So how can like other people say here that it is okay, you can, like, when we worship Gauranitai, it is not that strict. But as he sees, there are three personalities. So is it possible if we do lightly and we don't take seriously, like, is there anything Maharaj, you can teach him or guide him?
Well, Chaitanya, we don't worship Lord Chaitanya like he's Radha and Krishna, you know. Although we say that Lord Chaitanya is a combined form of Radha and Krishna, but remember, he's come in the Kali Yuga and he's come as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He's not come as Radha and Krishna. So we don't worship him like Radha and Krishna. He's come in a special mood, and he's come for the devotees in that particular role, and we have to accept that role. You can't make him Radha and Krishna, although he showed that he's not different from Radha and Krishna.
Yeah,
Maharaj,
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu jo ho, Radha ra Krishna ko swarup le raunu bhayeko cha, tara hamile wahalai Radha ra Krishna ko roop ma chai seva garna ya ta puja garne haina, kina bhane waha alagai bhinnai mood ma aunu bhayeko cha ra waha ko lakshya alagai cha ra waha chai Radha ra Krishna ho, waha ko roop ho, tara tes roop ma hamile puja garne haina bhanne bhanne huncha.
I was just yesterday, I was reading a purport where Prabhupada said we can worship Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Satbhuj, where he's the combined form of Rama and Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Yeah, Prabhupada said we could worship Lord Chaitanya like that. But if we worship Gauranitai, that is the... First of all, if Lord Chaitanya is there with Lord Nityananda, then Radha is not there. Wherever Radha and Krishna are together, Balaram is not there. You need to make separate altars. If you want to have Radha and Krishna and Gauranitai, you have to keep them separate, because Balaram does not come wherever Radha and Krishna are. So Gauranitai are Krishna and Balaram. There's no question of Radha being there. She cannot be there. Do you understand?
Maharaj, okay, he understood that, but there's one more thing. Like, when we worship Radha and Krishna Balaram also, it is strict. But when we worship Gauranitai, it's a bit not that strict compared to Krishna Balaram. So he also wants to know the reason why.
Because Lord Chaitanya is very merciful. Prabhupada said you can worship Gaur Nithai simply by kirtan. But Lord Krishna, he's the Supreme Personality of Godhead. You have to worship him very perfectly. Lord Chaitanya is in a different mood. Lord Chaitanya is Adarya Avatar, Mercy Incarnation. Okay.
Okay, Maharaj, thank you very much.
Thank you, Prabhu. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki. Thank you. Thank you, Radha Rani. Hare Krishna, Dhanavat Pranams.
Hare Krishna, Dhanavat Pranams.